A few days ago, I was invited by Screen West to a preview screening of Stan's new series, Population 11. The event gathered cast, crew, and some lucky people such as myself, as we got a chance to meet and talk to the cast and crew, and even got to watch the first two episodes of the show before the whole show drops on Stan March 14th. This video will be a bit of a mix of a vlog of the event itself, as well as my review of the first two episodes of the show, without any spoilers, of course. So I hope you go on to enjoy. So about a month ago, I got an email invitation from Screen West to this event, so I made sure to RSVP as soon as possible because I wanted to get in, and flash forward to the day before the event, and I was out drinking a lot. I woke up at 2 in the afternoon, which just so happened to be half an hour before the bus that would actually get me there on time was supposed to leave, so I rushed to get ready.
All right, this is the, I don't know what my clothes doing, but this is the outfit. It's the outfit. What are we thinking? I don't have many shoes. There's these nice black and yellow shoes I really want, but where am I gonna get the money from? I'm gonna finish the outfit, then I'm gonna go. Can I tell you a secret? I'm very hungover right now. I drank far too much last night. I am very hungover, but I'm going because I'm hoping Ben Feldman is gonna be there. So.
Then it was time for an hour and a half of public transport. This journey included a bus, a walk through the city, a stop at Woolworths for a Monster, whatever the hell this thing is, and then white people when there's coleslaw at the function. What's that? You didn't hear me? Oh, I said white people when there's coleslaw at the function. And then would you believe it, more walking and even a train, then somehow more walking. And I finally made it to Luna Cinemas in Leederville. Early, somehow. So I got myself some food because, like I said, I woke up half an hour before my bus. So I hadn't eaten anything by this point and I was starving. Finally, after a yummy set of Guzman and Gomez chips and waiting far too long in the foyer of the cinema, we were ushered into the event. We were greeted by this big open area with one of those photography wall thingies that you see in all those interviews. A worker showed us the door to the cinema, and I followed a bunch of people in and found a nice little seat. I saw those little director's chairs at the front of the stage, so I'm like, is there a chance the cast and crew are going to be here? Because by this point, I know I mentioned it in the intro, but by this point I didn't know. So I sat there patiently, but this is where things got a little bit strange. Only about 50 of the 300 or so people in the foyer were actually in the cinema. This event was supposed to start half an hour ago. What is going on? So quite simply, I stood up and I walked back outside and oh my god, there were the other 250 people that didn't follow us into the cinema. I walked around a bit, made some small talk with a bunch of people, and then through the crowd, I look up at the photo wall and saw the cast and crew of Population 11. Including but not limited to the star actor of this show, who had previously starred in one of my favorite shows of all time, Superstore, Ben Feldman. I was starstruck because I was standing just so damn close to the two lead actors, director, creator Phil Lloyd, who just so happened to make a little show you may have heard of, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, never heard of it. I wanted to try to talk to them. They were just talking to random people and I was a random person and still am. So I followed what I thought was a line to go and talk to them, but instead lined up to get a photo of myself in front of the photo wall where I awkwardly kind of stood like that Kevin James meme that was floating around a while ago. I made some friends in this line though, so shout out Ashley, Kat and Tracy. After being paparazzied, I was running out of time to get my chance to talk with Ben Feldman. If I didn't get this chance, I would have regretted it for God knows how long. So with that in mind, with that thought in my head, I went and just kind of awkwardly stood near him for about 2 minutes. That was until, surprise, surprise, Australian TikToker Emily Grosser came up to me and offered to help me out.
I'm waiting for my chance. Yeah, I know.
If you could, that would be great.
So with a new friend and some confidence, I continued to kind of just awkwardly stand there, just slightly to the right of the first spot that I was standing in, until I finally got the courage.
It's lovely to meet you.
Oh, good to meet you too.
I love your
background,
by the way.
Compared to Jonah.
Really? Well, now you get a chance to show everybody how much taller you are.
Okay, do you want a picture as well?
This was just insane. I have loved Superstore since like 2016, and now I'm talking to the guy that I took hair inspiration from. That's probably the least masculine thing I've ever said, but anyway. I got my video and I got my photos and introduced myself to Ben. And yes, I called him Ben because we're friends now. We're on first name basis.
Sweet.
Anyway, after a brief conversation about how high I wasn't high. Anyway, after a brief conversation, we headed inside for the screening. I took my seat, sat next to my new friends, and I listened to what people had to say. After a nice welcome to country, we heard from a Stan representative talking about the joy they've had developing content in Australia, specifically Western Australia. We heard from the Minister of Culture and the Arts, David Templeman, who talked about $19 million that's being put forward to help fund the film studio we're getting here in Western Australia, which is just awesome. Then we heard from the cast and the crew of the show, including stars Ben Feldman and Perry Mooney, creator Phil Lloyd alongside director Ben Young, and producers Bridget Callow-Wright and Melissa Kelly. It was such a great insight into what it was like filming here in Western Australia, and more specifically, Derby. And after this little Q&A, it was time to finally check out the first two episodes of Stan's Population 11. So let's talk about those without spoilers. Filmed in Western Australia and inspired by true events, Population is a quirky 12-part series about a man who goes missing from a tiny outback town of only 12 residents, 11 after the man goes missing, and his estranged son who journeys from the US to find him. When Ben Feldman's Andy Pruin pulls into this tiny outback town to visit his long-lost father, he's alarmed to discover that Hugo has somehow vanished, and all of the residents in the town are now suspects in his disappearance. Aided by another outsider, Cassie, played by Perry Mooney, Andy finds himself in increasing danger as he delves into the secrets of this band of outback weirdos in the quest to find his father. Episode 1 Outback UFO Tours sees a mysterious stranger named Andy arrive in the tiny outback town of Bidjigood in Western Australia, searching for a local man named Hugo who just so happens to be his father, only to discover that he's actually missing and that foul play might actually be involved in his disappearance. Episode 1 starts off really strong. It sets up this weird and wacky story, and it overall just sets the whole tone of the show very clearly, and it promises a strong and captivating cast of characters we'll eventually get to know. Speaking of, the cast of this show are all really great. My best friend Ben Feldman plays this fish out of water character really convincingly, and he just has so much lead presence on screen. It makes it really easy to fall in love with him and care about the journey he's being unfortunately led on. The side cast of characters really help round this show out. They're all locals to this small town, which is a strong contrast to Andy's American lifestyle. It's really enjoyable seeing them do their normal everyday things and Andy struggling with those same things. This show is a dark comedy, a drama, and a crime story all in one. The humor even works so well with the show's darker tone. We see a character get bitten by a snake and hit in the head with a shovel in the same episode that showed us Ben Feldman awkwardly blowing into a police officer's face. As far as first episodes go, this is really solid. This episode really nicely sets up the groundwork for the rest of the show. It shows us everything you need so well, from location, genre, characters, and themes. The cast is all likable and the story is engaging, and it is just a damn good time. Episode 1 gets a 4 out of 5 from me. Episode 2, Stray Dogs, picks up right where episode 1 left off and introduces us to Perry Mooney's Cassie, who begins helping Andy as he investigates Audrey, the local baker in Bidjigood, who's become the prime suspect in Hugo's disappearance when they find her secretly filling her pies with a mysterious meat. Episode 2 of Population 11 really nicely continues the tone and style that the first one set up so well. It also helps further the actual town as a character itself, not just the people of the town. There's a lot of aspects that really just show this environment Andy has been put into is its own wacky character with its own background and stories to tell, besides the people inside the town itself. Cassie is a great addition to the plot and gives a new character for Andy to bounce off of. She provides a stern and slightly less wacky tone compared to the rest of the townspeople. The story also goes a lot deeper here and doesn't lose any of its charm or humor. There's not much I can really say about this episode plot-wise without giving stuff away, but all you need to know is both episodes so far of this show have been really great at setting up what's coming next for the story and keeping you interested to watch the next episode. It does so well in the last few minutes to keep you so engaged that you just want to keep watching more, which is good because all 12 episodes drop on the same day. Population 11, Episode 2, Stray Dogs, gets another 4 out of 5 from me. And that's the first two episodes of Population 11 and the world preview screening itself. I am really excited for the rest of this show, and I am so, so grateful for Stan and Screen West for inviting me out. I'm not exactly sure what I did to get invited out, but I couldn't appreciate it more. It was such a fun event and a fun experience, and I had a great time networking with the cast, the crew, and fans alike, as well as watching the first two episodes of such a great show. When this video comes out, all 12 episodes of Population 11 should be streaming on Stan, so make sure you've got yourself an account. Make sure you've got yourself 6 hours to sit down and watch Population 11, because my best friend Ben Feldman is in it. I shook his hand. He introduced himself to me as Ben. All right, I love you guys. Thank you all very much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye for now.